everybody. Welcome to the Farmer's Market. My name is Joe Pollock, and right now I'm going to play a song from my new recording. The recording is called Zespero Je Silo Che, which is a Croatian word. It's mostly original music, but I did put two covers on it. One of them is The Wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald by Gordon Lightfoot, so I'm going to sing that right now. On from the Chippewa on down, off the big lake they call Kitchikoo. Lake, it is said, never gives up the dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With a load of iron ore 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. How true was it going to be true when the gales of November came early? The ship was the pride of American side, coming back from somewhere in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned, including some turns where the copper and steel firms. When they left fully loaded for Cleveland. And later that night when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they'd been feeling? Wind in the wires made a tattletale sound, and the wave broke over in the railing. As the captain did too, was the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. Supper time came, the old cook came on deck, saying, "Buzz, he's too rough to feed you." At 7 p.m. a main hatchway came in, he said, "Buzz, it's been good to know you." The captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the midship admiral was in peril. And later that night, when his lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn minutes to hours? The searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they'd put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up, or they might have capsized. They may have broke deep out to the water. And all that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Lake Huron rolls in the rear sands, in the ruins of her ice water mansions. Old Michigan steams like the unknown streams, the islands and veins of her sportsmen. And farther below Lake Ontario, takes in what they can be considered. And the iron boats go, as the mariners all know, with the gales of November in May. They prayed in the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. The church bell chanted and rang 29 times for each man of the blue light they called the chicken beer. Superior, they said, never gives up her dead when the gales of November come through. Gordon Lightfoot, the record of Edmund Fitzgerald.
Thank you. That was beautiful.
Thank you.
How much are your CDs?
The one with the record of Edmund Fitzgerald is 20.
This one here?